Okay, we're making sushi rice. We have gone through the steps that I described earlier. We rinsed the rice very, very well until the water was running clear. Then we soaked the rice for an hour. Then we strained it gently. We dried it for a half an hour. Then we combined it with equal parts of water. So we had by volume equal parts of water and rice. We steamed it for 25 minutes. While it was steaming, we made a seasoned liquid of vinegar, sugar, salt, and kombu seaweed, sweet, sour, salty, umami. And the hungiri, the wooden barrel that is used for cooling and seasoning the rice, was soaked with water to make it moist but not saturated. The rice has just come out of the steamer. We're going to gently put it into the hungiri. And again, gently stirring the rice that comes out of the steamer. Stirring the rice for sushi is going to turn it into more like a creamy risotto style rice rather than distinct individual grains. If you look in a sushi roll, well-made sushi, the rice is each individual grain is distinct from the other. Just a little bit of starch holding them together. Rice, sushi is all about the rice and how it is cleaned, how it is cooked, and how it is seasoned is what makes good sushi. Now a sushi chef will apprentice for a minimum of 5 years. And generally speaking, the first 2 years, all they get to do is wash the rice. It's only until the last year or two of their apprenticeage that they start to get involved with the garnishes, the fish, the vegetables, the almonds. So the rice is the utmost important thing. Sushi is not defined by its garnish, it's defined by the rice, and so it has to be taken care of. I'm not a sushi chef, I don't claim to be one, I didn't do a 5-year apprenticeship. I know a little bit more than most of you, and maybe not as much as some of you. This is the very basics. Oftentimes, when the rice turns out okay, it's an accident, to be quite frank, because we don't have the skill of repetition of several years of working with the rice. It's something that I do every 3 weeks for an hour. It's something that you might have never done before, probably will not get a chance to do for quite some time. So it's not something that I get too concerned about. I know good sushi rice when I see it. Sometimes I get lucky and I make it well myself. If it doesn't turn out perfectly, I'm not going to be particularly upset. I just want you to understand that, you know, the right way. Now, if you could step forward, Dominic. Traditionally, you go to the fan. Traditionally, while you're cooling the rice, while you're seasoning it and folding it, letting the steam escape, someone would be standing with a bamboo fan and fanning it off to get rid of the excess moisture, the excess steam. We don't have a beautiful fan, so a blue plastic cafeteria tray works just fine. I'm going to have someone take over for me now, and we're going to continue to just very gently fold this and fan it until the rice stops giving off steam. Just about skin temperature. If you want to check, just put the back of your hand on it. When it's just about skin temperature, it should be done. Try not to overwork it. Be gentle, big broad folding strokes so we don't break the rice and turn it into mush. It looks like it was fairly well cooked. It was a little bit moist when it came out of the steamer, but that's one of the purposes of the hungiri, is the porous wood will absorb some of the excess liquid. And the rice looks like it's coming out okay. When the steam is finished dissipating and it is about room temperature, skin temperature, you can then divide it into three pans for the sushi station setups. Okay? Thank you.